This is the cathode and that's the anode, right? Okay, good. Well, hello. Today we're talking about the ideal diode as it's a switch. And here's the symbol for the diode. And you can see that this is the cathode and this is the anode. I usually don't remember which is which. I just remember how it works. So from the body of the diode, you can see that there's a kind of an arrow going in this direction. It means current can flow in this direction. But there's this bar here, and that means that current cannot flow in the other direction. So it blocks the current flow in the opposite direction. And so the current flow we expect to go in this way. And we've labeled the voltage over the diode from here to here. So when the switch is on, current flows through it, and the voltage of the diode will be some value. We call this the forward voltage, V forward, and in the true ideal case, it would be zero. So let's draw that first. We can represent the operation of the diode on this voltage current curve, and we know that when it's on, that any current, for any current, the voltage here will be zero. So that's represented here, and we call this, we say it's on, the switch is on. When it's off, there's no current, so the current is zero, and it can block any voltage. So if this voltage is higher than this voltage, it can block any voltage in the ideal case. So we would draw that this way, here. This would be off. So this is the basic operation for an ideal diode, where we assume the forward voltage is zero. There's another case where we assume that there is some forward voltage. So let's change the forward voltage to some value. Let's just say 1 volt, for example. And this changes our representation a little bit. When current is flowing in this direction, there is a voltage that's here based on the diode properties of the diode. And we just estimate that as an ideal 1. So 1 volt, whatever voltage we put here. When we represent that here on this graph, all this does is shifts this point over a little bit. So now we have, when it's on, current flowing, there is a voltage drop here of about 1 volt. So now we can represent that here. This voltage will be VF, the forward voltage. And then when current is not flowing, it can block anywhere up to the 1 volt. So it's essentially represented here and just shifts that over a little bit. When we have current and a little bit of voltage, we're going to have some power loss. So if we want to look at the conduction loss for a diode, we go back to the basic equation, P equals IV, the voltage times the current. So P loss will equal, in this case, whatever the diode current is, and it can be any value, so we'll use this variable ID, whatever the current is to the diode, times the forward voltage, so VF here. In the ideal case, this is zero, then you have zero power loss. Otherwise, if you have some forward voltage, you'll get this amount of power loss. And this is just conduction loss. We're not counting any switching losses for this case, but this is a nice simple equation that I'll leave you with.